What up, it's your girl Minna. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I want to break down for the beginners in the makeup world, makeup terminology that is commonly used by influencers, makeup artists like myself that may be confusing to you and you just might not know about because you're new, you just started. So if you're excited, give the video a thumbs up, make sure you are subscribed. Oh, and also I have a bun going on, which you can't see. So this looks kind of weird. I'm out of the frame and I got a little situation. Things going on and a tan. There's a lot happening right now. Tan, the bun is out of the frame. It's like, should I talk like this? Okay, anyway, I digress. This makeup look is my basic makeup look. I've done a video here on YouTube. Take a look at my beginner makeup tutorials and you'll find this look. Because I know you're gonna ask. Let's talk about highlight and contour. Highlight is a concealer that is lighter than your skin tone. So I like to go really, really light, but you know, they say 2 to 3 shades lighter than your actual foundation color. So it's a light concealer. Concealer because it dries down more full coverage and it's less movable than foundation really, sometimes more pigmented. So we use a concealer to highlight and we put the concealer in the areas that we want to highlight. So under the eyes, middle of the forehead, down the nose, above the lip and the chin. And I put my concealer under my cheekbones to accentuate the cheekbones. Okay. So, but you can put your concealer in as few of those areas as you would like, or in all of those areas. It is your face. It is your highlight. You highlight in the way you want to do it. I've seen people bring their highlight around their mouth, all kind of things. Okay. Depends on your face and what you want, but that is where I put my highlight. And that's a light concealer. Okay. Now highlight is also used for a shimmer highlight. So the product that is right here above my lip, middle of my nose, forehead, chin, not under my cheeks though, but just what I just said, that's a highlight also, but it's a shimmer highlight. But confusingly enough, we don't call it a shimmer highlight. We just call it a highlight again. So I want you to understand that there's the concealer highlight and then there's the shimmer highlight, which is what you put on afterward. The concealer highlight in my makeup routine, that is step number 2. I do foundation, then I do my concealer highlight. Okay, so my highlight concealer. So then there's contour. Contour brings back the shadow to your face, and that's because you put on the foundation, you put on your highlight concealer. If you do all these steps, you can do all or just some of these steps, but if you're doing a full face beat, you're gonna do all of these. Okay, so the contour is gonna bring back the shadow to your face because when you put on your foundation, especially if it's full coverage, it's going to even out your whole face and you're gonna look flat, which is fine because then we're gonna highlight to brighten some areas and then we're gonna contour to give you that shadow. So the contour goes on the perimeter of the face. You can do it in a 3 form, so it can go 1, 2, right, to look like a 3 on both sides. Although I don't contour my jawline, you can if you want. The jawline area I leave free of makeup because it's too messy, but that's where you bring the shadow. I also contour my nose, as you can see, because I do want there to be a shadow on the sides of my nose to make my nose appear to be more narrow. Alrighty, if you do your foundation and you highlight and you don't contour, it's gonna look ridiculous unless your highlight is not too light. If your highlight is subtle and you're doing a quick face, you can totally just do your foundation, your highlight, put some powder on your face, you already have full brows, get a little gloss, a little blush, and call it a day. You could do whatever you want with your face, but the question is, how do you want it to look? Based on how you want it to look, that is how you will apply your makeup. When it comes to the contour and the highlight, to me, they go hand in hand. They just go hand in hand. Let's just leave that as a rule of thumb, shall we? Praise the Lord. I've heard a lot of people refer to foundation as base. I heard it the first time when I was a makeup artist at MAC, a freelance artist, and someone came in and was like, yeah, I'm looking for a base. I was like, and she was a Nigerian lady too. So I thought maybe it was like a cultural thing. And I'm like, base, huh? And she said, she had foundation. And I was like, oh, okay, foundation. And I didn't hear about it again until maybe a few years ago, like a year or so ago. And people would say, oh, your base looks good. And I'm like, huh? Base? That's because I'm moi. What do you mean by that? And I'm like, do people call the foundation base? I guess if you think about it, that is the base of the makeup. It is the first thing that I do after the primer, but I've never thought about it that way. I mean, do you call it a base? Comment, let me know. I mean, I'm dumbfounded. So there's the base. It's your foundation. Praise God. The highlight, I told you where you highlight, right? With the highlight concealer, okay? You also highlight under the brow. Again, that's if you do your makeup like I do. I've seen several videos where the artists do not highlight under their brow. They just don't want to. It's to each their own. I highlight under my brow. It helps to carve out the brow, give it a great shape, a lift. It looks awesome. Back in the day, I used to put a shimmer highlight in my brow in the corner where my highlight, where the highlight concealer goes, but I don't do that anymore. Some people do. It's really up to you. Lip primer. Primer is important, okay? Again, you could do whatever you want, but if you're doing it like I do it, primer is important. I always wear a lip primer regardless if I'm wearing lip stain, lipstick, lip gloss. You need a lip primer, okay? So that is important. Face primer, of course, creates a barrier between your skin and the product, and it also can help do what you need it to do. So whatever that is, if it's mattification, if it's glow, if it's like covering the pores, you know, giving you a smooth base, that all depends. So make sure you are wearing a primer, and that's just what that means. It preps the skin, but really you put it on beneath it so that it does what you need it to do. Another thing too is face powder. So I use face powder. A lot of people do not use face powder. Many people I've seen will do their foundation, their highlight concealer, their contour. They'll, I don't know, like I guess they'll use a setting powder. The setting powder usually is like translucent, doesn't really add coverage. And then they go on and on and on. And I gotta be honest, back in the day, I never even set my highlight concealer. I didn't set it. I used to use MAC Pro Longwear and it set itself. And I was still beginning, so I didn't think I needed it. And then I grew up and I was like, wait a minute, I'm about to start setting my highlight concealer. And it was just like a snowball effect from there. And then here we are. So you have the face powder for me. That powder is a setting powder. Yes, takes down the oils, but it also, I like to use powders that have color to it because I want to bring back some warmth to the face because I like to use a really light highlight. The face powder really brings the face in so that neither the highlight concealer nor the contour look too harsh. I want them to look blended, nice, beautiful. If you've seen my videos, then you've seen me use a powder on my face, and that's my face powder. It has a color to it. So I've used the Sephora Micro Smooth powder in Deep Ebony. I've used the CoverGirl powder in the color Deep Cool 2. You know, several different ones. The what, e.l.f. Cosmetics setting powder, I think it's Deep or something like that. I like for the powder to have some color so that there's no harsh line between the contour and the concealer. So I recommend if you want to follow my routine, then you make sure you have a face powder that matches your skin tone. It might sound counterproductive, but honestly and truly, if you love the way my makeup looks, I'm trying to tell you what I do. You do your foundation, your highlight concealer, you do your contour, you put your face powder on top, you do your eyebrows, you do your eyeshadow if you want to, you do your lashes, you put your face powder on the rest of your face, and then you put your contour on again, because you know there's cream contour and there's powder contour. Then you're gonna do your shimmer highlight. Then you're gonna put your blush on, and then you're gonna do your lip. You just need to watch my videos, okay? Like I can't, okay? I just can't watch the videos. And I do have a beginner makeup playlist. Not too wild, I don't think. Although you might look at them and think like, whoa, I don't know. Yeah. All right, I mentioned bronzer. What is that? Bronzer adds warmth to the face. Usually the bronzer is going to be red, warm. Now, we don't want bronzer to be too red, you know? And if you want, I can do a video on bronzers that I have. Comment and let me know. Contour adds a shadow, but I've used warm products to contour. So I suppose if you think about it, I was contouring and bronzing, I think is the word. Are you confused? You should be. Okay, so like for instance, when I use Juvia's Place Shade Stick in the color Congo, Congo is warm. It's a foundation that I use to contour. But because it's warm, it's really kind of a bronzer, but it's a cream product. It's not a powder, you see? Bronzers are powder products. Pressed powder in a press, like a compact, okay? Bronzers are in a compact, and bronzers are normally warm. Please don't be confused. I'm trying to help you. I do cream contour, and you can watch my videos and see, but I, especially in the summertime now, I like to go over the cream contour with a powder bronzer at a certain point, and that looks really cute because it adds that warmth to the face. I did do a bronzer today. It's very subtle, but you see it, you know what I'm saying? Bronzer is cool, and that's powder. Cool, not cool as in the color tone. It is awesome. Bronzer is awesome, and I like to use it. You can or you can't, you can skip it, okay? If you do contour and you don't want a bronze, that's fine. I've done that for years. But if you do your contour and you want a bronze, go for it. Again, you do what you want to do. Okay? Okay. Then there's a stippling brush. So the stippling brush is really important. The stippling brushes will give you less product. So if you're wanting to apply a light amount of your product, then you can use a stippling brush to apply it. If you want to apply a large amount of your product, for instance, when I'm putting on my face powder because I want the color on my face, I will use a kabuki brush. Normally a flat kabuki, but I am these days is using a kind of dense fluffy brush. Again, I just want to pack on the color, pack on the punch. But if you're wanting a light application of your powder or even your foundation, I used to use a stippling brush for my foundation back at MAC. That was a thing too. You can use a stippling brush, okay? Then you have the Kabuki. They're more dense, they're thick, they're kind of stiff. I like to use those because when I put on my full coverage foundation, I want it to really just like be on. Understand that when I'm putting on my foundation, I'm not putting on a can of paint. I'm not putting on frosting, okay? There isn't a thick layer of frosting on my face because I use full coverage foundation. I digress, but it's important. When you're using full coverage foundation, you're not gonna need as much of the foundation. It's full coverage. You don't need as much. I've explained this in videos, but we're doing this one, so let's bring it all in. When you do your eyeshadow, really quickly, you have your transition color. The transition color is the color between your brow bone highlight concealer and your actual crease. So if you see, I've got this reddish orange color right here. That's called the transition color. I believe that every person on the planet needs to use a transition color in their eyeshadows. Are you going to see that? No. People are different and they do what they want to do. But if you want your face to look like mine, I'm telling you, I use a transition color every single time I do my eyeshadow. There's no such thing as an eyeshadow look for Mina Dubia without a transition color. Very, very important. Okay, then you have your crease. The crease is the deep set part of your eyes. But if you have eyes like mine, you'll see that there's a natural fold right here. But that is not what I consider to be my crease. When I raise my forehead up, naturally part of my eye will sink in and it's right here. So if you just pinch with the back of a makeup brush, or I have my nails, so I'm doing that, pinch and you'll see where the eyeball is and where your brow actual bone is. That is your crease. So when you're using a crease color, which is normally the darker color on your face, unless you're doing a smoky eye, then it's just all over the lid. Make sure that that crease color is right here in this section, okay? So as you're applying with your brush, isolate the crease and put that crease color in there. Normally your crease color for beginners will be like a brown. No matter what skin tone you have, brown is a safe way to go. It usually matches everyone's hair, whether it be light brown if you're very fair or dark brown if you have deep skin. You wanna put that in the crease. Try to isolate the crease. Then you have your lid. So you have your lid color, which is all on the eyeball. So if you touch your eye, everything that covers the eyeball, that is your lid. So normally if your lid color is lighter than your crease color, it helps the eye to pop. You look more wide awake. If you have any other questions about makeup terminology, I want you to comment and leave them below. If you have any suggestions on videos that I can make to help teach you about makeup as a beginner, I want you to let me know as well. I've mentioned in another video, but I want to say it again. I love to do the tutorials and reviews and so forth, but I actually literally want you to learn how to do your makeup. I want you to not just watch me, like do that and share and all of those things, but I want you to know what you're doing, right? Like why would you want to spend hundreds of dollars month after month racking up all this makeup that comes out because it looks awesome, because we use it, but then when you sit down, you don't know what you're doing. I want you to know what you're doing to help you out. I want to hear within a few months, years, I don't know how quickly you learn. I want to hear, wow, I learned this and now I can do my face. I don't want you to follow me and not know what intonation you're doing unless you don't have a goal to learn. You could just want to be entertained. You could just think I'm funny and that's all you want to get from me, and that's fine too. But if you want to learn how to do makeup, I want to help you do that. And I'm glad that you're here. Thanks for watching and make sure you subscribe, okay? Bye.